Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this is a video showing you the bags that come with the light console. And this is one of the bags. As you can see, it's exceedingly big. It's very baggy, and in this video I'm going to show you the bags and also the console and how you put the console in the bags. Right, this is a bag, and it's actually it's quite big. Very quickly as well, if you're part of the mob and stuff, and you like to get rid of people in very inappropriate ways. Anyway, we won't go there. But first of all, you probably want to know what light console is. It's that thing over there. So what we'll do now, I'll take you over there, we'll have a look at it with some kit on, and then what I'm going to do in this video, I'm going to pull it apart, I'm going to put it in the bags, and there's that one, I'm going to put it in the bags, and then take it out of the bags and put it back together again. Now bear in mind as well that all these videos I do is my own work, so no one's told me what to do or what to say. I haven't been contacted by the companies and they've gone, you must do this, or if you don't do that, we'll send the boys around, put you in a bag and break your arms. Did they say it? No. Anyway, so this is all me, my work, just punk style, showing you exactly what's going on. So don't move and I'll have a closer look at that. Ah! Don't move. Right, here we go. Light console. And as you can see at the moment, it's got stuff all around it and all over it. So if I just go around this side. There you go. What I will do is I will unplug everything. And in the next snippet, you'll see that just by itself in the middle of sort of there-ish. So hold tight. And with the wonders of technology, there it is. Right, if you want measurements, I will I'll put all measurements in the description. Also a link to the website. Very quickly as well, you'll notice a couple of LED lights there. They're there to light up the side panels. But bearing in mind that it's up to you what you want to do. You could have up lighting, down lighting, side lighting, left and right lighting in here. Doesn't really matter, because it's down to the individual who wants to, you put your own effects in there, basically. Right, side panel, look at that. Hold on, one-handed. There you go, like so. Okay, also if you take a look at the top, that can be removed like that, and it gives you adequate space, fish, chips, burgers, etc. Or if you want to, you could put your DJ gear on there as well. Alright, looking at the top of the unit, you've got space for at least three players, and then down there you can put your mixer, but of course you've got adequate space for, well, anything and everything really. Small but genius, small hole for your cables, goes through there. Another one you can see there, and stereo the other side, and then down at the bottom as well. Right, now front of the unit we've got quite a large panel. This has been designed so you can have the panel like so. Alternatively, you can take this away, which I will show you very shortly, and you maybe put a plasma there as well. So maybe you're a VJ, etc., or maybe you're at, say, a particular event and they want some sort of visual effects. Simple. I'll show you that in a minute. Hold on. Right, what we'll do now, I'll take that way, like so, and then front panel here, just lift crap on the floor. Sorry. Right, I'll leave that in. That's my fault. I just put it there. Sorry. I apologise. So, it is as simple as that. That's it. There you go. Right, I'm going to put that there. And this. All right. Very makeshift, but you can see we have light console. So, think about it. Any form of light, in fact, any kind of light, LED or dichroic, it doesn't really matter, that will shine up that. So I'm going to put that there, and I'm going to put that there. And let's turn this off. Very simple as well. Looking at the back of the unit, we've got four clamps. So it's just a question of unclamping, and then you can remove the front panel. Now also, again, if you look at those, clamps like that, or those two bars will give you the endless possibilities of attaching the likes of flat screen TV. You could even have a flutter if you wanted. If you really, really, really wanted. Right, all the clamps have been loosened, and also, small point, you'll notice that that panel has now not dropped on any of the audience. So what I'll do now is just go outside, take that away, and there it is. Right, I'll put that over there. Okay. Getting closer now to the framework. So top comes off like so. There you go. And stop going blurry. Thank you. You'll notice exceedingly simple attachment. If I just put it in that sort of direction, like so. There you go. I mean, these are relatively heavy. I'm not gonna joke there. But very solid. I'm going to take that off and put that over there. And the other one. I'm going to pull off. And put that over there. Right. I've done this before, haven't I? Light console. Is it light? Right, this one's slightly bigger than the other one. So this should be quite interesting. Put it like that. There we go, don't move. Right. If you can see me looking in that direction, it's got a TV screen out there. Ooh, hold on. Oh shit. Right. I'll have to move that cable first, hold on. Right, cable removed. Here we go. Yes! I did it! Yep. Alright. I don't actually advise you to do that because it could fall on someone. Right, let me show you now how to dismantle the unit, because we have these bars which are holding the two side bits together. Hold tight. Right, on this guy, eight bars. On each side of every single bar, you've got these guys. You can see, flick in, and of course, if you think about it, if you've got eight of those, or eight bars, that means 16 lots of these guys. How on earth are you supposed to pull this apart? Well, let me demonstrate. I'll just pause the camera again. Right, now, if you're a baker, you'd know it's called using your loaf. I'm going to press those two in. Now, I'm going to turn that bar. That's it. So if you imagine you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Press in and turn, what you're doing is you're disengaging the small little bits there. You can hear them click in, like so. So press in and twist. So all I need to do is do that to every bar, and then the sides should pull apart. I mean, should, they will pull apart. A better ad. Right, I'm going to use the laws of gravity now. All of those bars are ready to go. If I pull this across like that, all those bars probably might stay there. Some may sort of sit there and wonder what's going on. Alternatively, we could have a bit of a mess up. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn it the other way around. Hold on. or on its end.
Right, I'm going to take that off. So, can you tell I've done this before? Oh, there you go, I've got a couple of bars holding onto the top, but there you go. Right. Alright, so I've got bits all over the place. Here's the deal. If you are going to spend a vast amount of money on something like this, because it's not that cheap really, you're probably going to have the bags because you want it looked after. So, what I'm going to try and do now, I'm going to do it, is I'm going to put all the bits in the bags. So, right, first of all, side bits. Again, you've got your motif there, so probably a good idea to put them like that, back to back. So I'll just pause the camera. Right, I've got those nicely in there. All right, next one, long one with its own separate compartment that's got some Velcro attached. And there's also, I love this, a bag in a bag. Now that one, is definitely not for the Mrs. Hairdryer, but it is for those guys. So let's put it in. So in that one, we've got the angled unit that sits on top of the light console and the 8 bars. One quick point as well, Velcro. Good idea. I'll be honest with you, zips, give it half a dozen times, unless it's a good quality zip, probably fall apart, but I mean, Velcro can't really go wrong. Right, do apologise, my fault, first time I've done this. That guy there, you can put that in there as well. Good. There we go. You could always put a bit of material or something in between, or there is like this small partition there piece. So maybe that could even go on the top of there. But that seems quite happy alternatively though, thinking about it. I could take the bars out of there. It's already in their own bag. I could put, yes, that's what they've done. Of course. Duh, partition there. Bag with bars on top of there. Genius, look at that. Flipping it, oh my goodness. Oh, no wonder I was never a rocket scientist. Right, I'm going to Velcro that up, and I'm going to put that over there. Don't go away. Ooh. Right, this is a rather large big bag. Very quickly as well. If by any chance you've got an artist in the family, do not show them these bags, because this is exactly the sort of thing that an artist would like to have put their rather large canvases in, so I suggest you hide it. Alright, there's that. And I'm going to put those pieces in there. Right, bear with me. Right, I've got the one shelf in there. So I'm just going to grab that and put that one in there. Right, put it that way. Like that. There we go. Bit of Velcro. I think I'm an artist. No, not a piss artist. Only on Saturdays. Right. Right. Least but not last is the biggest bag of them all. And at the beginning of this video, you might have noticed a nutter in a bag. Of course, I was in that one. By the way, girls and boys, if you are watching this, it's not a good idea to go into bags because you could suffocate. Alternatively, if all of a sudden your mum and dad decide or start talking secretly, and you can't understand what's happening. And then, let's say, for example, you see lots of big bags at the front door, and something to do with Thomas Cook, or I don't know, or like holiday, then it might be a good idea to sneak in one, because it means you go on holiday. That's, of course, if they're doing it behind your back. But still, don't go in bags, because you could suffocate. Right, so what I'm going to do first, pause the camera, because it'll, you don't really want to watch me. Yeah, alright. Okay, and you can watch me suffering to try and put this in. It's quite a big, yeah, right, it's quite a big bag actually. So, right, what I'm going to do is, I don't know. See, I can tell, Like, no, you should be seeing what you're doing, mate. See, this is the first time I've done this, so I don't know if I should have the partition in or out or. Right, I'm going to take the partition away. Move that. Which of course, it's velcroed, it's not tipping, ripping, sorry. Anybody ever wash ripping yarn? Fantastic. Right, so that's that one in there. And then I'm going to get the other one and put the other one in. Right, so over there. And then rip that the other way. Yeah, probably rip that the other way. I put it the other way that we can get the partition. In fact, what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to pause the camera, put the partition in, you can have a look. So, we've got one of them in, and got partition in as well. If I lift that up, there you go. So what I'll do, I'll pause the camera, put the camera back on the stand, and bung the other one in. Right, my fault, I did actually have, sorry, you are there. I did have the first one in the wrong way round, so I've put it in the right way wrong now. No, the right way round, wrong way. It's in the right way this time anyway. So, there you go. Right, there you go. Last piece in a bag. Now, me personally, I'm always wary about bags because it's not like a hard flight case. A hard flight case, you can literally batter it around and it's going to last indefinitely. Cool, so look, it's, again, it's as long as you look after it. But bags, they rip, they tear, etc. The only thing I will say about these is that they will protect what's inside them. Full stop, they're going to. But if you're going to have your items, the pieces in here, and then all of a sudden just chuck them in the back of the van or the lorry so they're waving and wobbling about all the place, and then they're starting to rub on other items, then they're not gonna last. So again, very simple. If you're going to spend a vast amount of money on a light stand, you're going to buy the bags. If you're going to buy the bags, then what you're going to do when you put it in to a form of transport, you're going to make damn sure that they're secure. Now this guy here is a two-man lift. Even though you saw me earlier lift it with the bars, you've got a handle there and a handle there. So unless you are someone like me who can do that, I would recommend two people, but you can do that actually. As crazy as it sounds, little trolley underneath, trolley, dolly, there you go. Alright now, a bit of a video here for a company called LiteConsole. Like I said, I will put a hyperlink in the description down there that will take you directly to the website. Also, on the website, I would have thought you've got your usual emails, contacts, so if you are interested, go and check them out. And also check out their Facebook page, which I will put on here as well. All right, so yeah, practice and enjoy. And I've got to set this back up now. Right. Yvette, give us a hand.